Hello, this is Mike Zamuda with techytube.com, and today we're going to look at the alignment of elements, how to change the margin, and how to add a navigation app bar. So first thing we're going to start with is the alignment. I'll flip into Visual Studio really quick here. So we'll basically pick a random element. Sure, let's try the navigation button. And now to change the alignment, just have to pop open layout, not surprisingly. And as we can see, we just have some glyphs down here. And you probably tell what these mean, but we'll go through them. For horizontal, there's left, center, right, and stretch. So basically, to fill your current parent container you're in. And vertical alignment, we have top, centered, bottom, or again, stretch to fill the vertical space of your container. So we'll just see what some of those might look like. Now it's set to left. Line it to center. You can see centered and you can see the lines extending to the edge of the container. And then we can move over to the right and then we can make it stretch. For a button, you probably don't want to do this, but handy for some panels or other similar things. So we'll set that to back to left, and I'll try the verticals. So top is where we're at right now. Center, bottom, and stretch. Now these aren't taking effect on this button because the way it's nested in the containers, but putting items into XAML, there is something you really have to take time to learn about because it's just like designing web pages with HTML and CSS. There's a lot to know about and a lot you have to know to make layouts go smoothly. So that is the vertical alignment. I'll go back on that. And now for the margin, the left margin, say we want this to be 50 px out. There we go. And you see the actual value we use for the margin, 50 right there. So we'll just do that with a few of these properties so you can see what they do. Now that won't have too much influence here, but if we change the alignment to right, we see that 50 appear on that part instead. So we'll switch it back to left. And not surprisingly, the last one is the bottom. Again, not going to have too much influence on our button because of the vertical issues with it, but that's where you would set it. So we'll set those all back to zero, and that's basically alignment and setting margins. So next, we will need to add our navigation bar. Now, you might be asking why we're doing this since we already added a button, but the navigation button really shouldn't be in like the main view of your application because it's more of a secondary operation compared to what your app is designed to do. So an app bar, as we've looked at before, is something that happens when you either swipe the corners or go right click. So you can see the Internet Explorer app bar has the back glyph, which we've used. It's got refresh, a few other things. And to the top, this is their navigation app bar. So as you can see, I have another page open. So this is how you would actually navigate between your different pages you have open in Internet Explorer. So get out of that, or just go right click again. So what we're going to do is select the page root element in the document outline on mainpage.xaml. So what we'll do is make sure we have main page open, resize that a little bit. Yep, main page is open. So then we're going to go to the was it other windows document outline or control alt D. There we are. And I'll flip back to our tutorial real quick. There we go. So we're gonna use the document outline to select the page root element because it's a little bit easier than digging through the designer. And then we're gonna look at properties. So we're going to select page root. Selected. Now we will open our properties window up a little bit. And what we're going to do is go to the top app bar property. And then there's going to be a new button. So this is basically a really easy way to add an app bar control. It's kind of like dropping components onto a Windows Forms project or having a component project, but a little bit different. So here's what we're going to do. Yeah, page root, top app bar. So as you can see, we don't have anything here right now, but we definitely do want to have one, and also bottom app bar. So those are the two positions you can have, as we saw in Internet Explorer. Top app bar generally used for navigation, but that is up to you. So we're going to go new, and have to wait for, there we go. So as you can see by the parentheses, this is basically an instance of app bar. So that's now been created and is added to our project. You won't see it here, obviously, because this is your main view, but trust Visual Studio, it is there. So now, how do we get at basically putting this app bar into our applications? Well, there's actually a really easy way to do it via drag and drop. So that method is, after adding your app bar, you go to the document outline, you expand the top app bar property, and then you select whichever page or element you want that app bar to apply to. Drag the element onto the app bar, not the other way around, element onto the app bar, and drop it. So here's what we're going to do. Flip back to Visual Studio, document outline. There we go. So there's top app bar right there. Just expand that. There we go. So we want to use this on our photo page. So we'll just drop. There we go. So don't drop it on the kind of the parent type there of the top app bar. Drop it onto the instance in the brackets instead. And there we go. So all pages that use this app bar will appear under here. And as we can see, that is the photo page. Alrighty. And one last thing, we'll want to set this to go forward, basically to the right. As the back glyph will already be appearing in the left part of the window. So it's gonna go that selected layout, and we're gonna go right justified, right layout. Perfect. As you can see, it's appears in the app bar, and you will eventually be able to see that, but it's kind of hidden from you in the designer until you're actually doing things up there. So that's basically it. So now we're going to run this application. All right, so compiled and ready to rock. You'll notice we don't have any title text here. It's because it's something we did in the previous video with resetting layout values, so don't worry about that. We're going to right click, and as we can see, the button we drag onto the top app bar is there. So we're going to click go to photo page, and there we are. So that's basically a way to move your navigation items and group them in a place that makes more sense than just kind of hanging around in the middle of your application. But that's basically it. So this time we finished off some layout concepts and the implementation with the alignment and margins. And we also added a app bar and added one of our pre-existing buttons to it very easily. So you can see how Visual Studio really lets you drag and drop and make things really simple, and lets you focus more on actually laying things out than the details around that. So that's it for this time. Next, we are going to once again take the basic default app bar button we've created, and we are going to style it. But that's next time, so thanks for listening, and we'll see you on the next video.